Today I'm going to be talking through how to make your own training plan to accomplish your goals. I get asked this all the time, how do I do so many different disciplines like calisthenics, weightlifting, gymnastics, tricking, and seem to get better at all of them at the same time? Most people think I just do them all at the same time and get better at them, but that's not the case. If I want to get better at something, the main thing I'll do is just focus on that one thing. For example, when I wanted to get a bench PB last year, I did a bench program solidly for a month, and all I did was bench press, nothing else. I gained 10 kilos on my bench and got a PB, and that is true of any goal that I want to get. If you want to get something, focus on that only. So with that said, let's get into my program and how I made it and how you can make yours. Right, the first and most important step is to decide what your goals are. It's no good just having some generic goal like, oh, I want to get in good fitness this year, because you're never going to know whether you achieve it or not. If you have clear, cut, defined goals, then it's going to be much easier to accomplish them and set a deadline on those. So that's the first thing I'm going to do here. So I always write my programs in Excel. I only have Excel on my work laptop, so I'm having to show you how I did this on Excel online, because I can't screen capture on my work laptop. This is what I'll do. I'll write everything out on Excel, and then I can formula drive all the weights. So if I ever need to change anything, all I do is update one cell with a max lift, and it will change the rest of the program for me. So I have weightlifting goals, powerlifting goals, calisthenics goals, flexibility goals, and tricking goals. So I'm just going to skip to the final document on Google Sheets. There's a link to the document in the description so you can have a look for yourself. And if you want to use this as a base template for your own kind of thing, you can do that. Just change it as you need to. Okay, here's the goals written out in final form. So if I want 4x bodyweight sumo deadlift at 66 kilos, I need to lift 265 kilograms. Now, so that's the first goal, the bodyweight, 66 kilograms. So with every goal, you're going to need to set a deadline. So my deadline for this goal is 30th of April, because that's when the weather's going to start getting warm and I want to focus mainly on tricking at that point in time. So I want to be as light as possible, because tricking is much easier when you are lighter. So now I have to go into detail of how I'm going to do that. So if I want to do it by April, I'm going to write out all the days up to April and how much I need to weigh each day in order to make sure I hit that goal by the time end of April rolls round. So I've done a few calculations here. I've basically done 8 kilograms, which is what I need to lose, because I started at 74, divided by the number of days from the start of the year to April. That means I need to lose 67 grams per day. So I've done a little calculation of what the previous day weight was, what I need to weigh today, and then I enter what I actually weighed. If I've conditionally formatted the extra loss or gain, this is what I'm talking about using Excel with formulas, which makes it easier. If I enter a number higher than I'm supposed to be, then it's going to go red. So I immediately know I've missed my target for that day. So I need to not eat so much food that day. I should weigh myself every morning and write these numbers in. Easy as that. If I'm on track, then by April, I'll be 66 kilos. Everything's broken down into stages by day, so that it's easy to accomplish. If you just say, oh, I want to be 66 kilos, but don't actually plan how you're going to do that, you're never going to achieve it, because you're just going to hope it happens and April's going to roll around and nothing will have changed. All right, so step one's done. You've written all your goals down. Step two is to put a deadline on all those goals. So I've written out the year here by month and labeled every single Monday in each month. Now, what I'm going to do is have a main focus, a secondary focus, and a maintenance focus. So in the first month up to April, which when the weather gets warm, I just want to maintain my powerlifting and weightlifting goals. I want to improve calisthenics a bit, and my main focus is tricking. The first month for me is actually a conditioning month because I had knee surgery, but for other people they probably won't have that. So then I've got my goal sections written out here: tricking, flexibility, calisthenics, weightlifting. All my goals fall into one of those categories, and here is the deadlines on each. So in January I need to get to my pre-surgery level. By the end of February, I need to land all the level one goals on my tricking lists. So I labeled them in difficulty. These are all things that I think will take me a month to land or get clean. Some of them I can already do, hence that's why they're in level one difficulty. Level two tricks are gonna be slightly harder, and they're gonna be landed in March, and so on and so on. My flexibility goals are also written out. The ankle to the head I needed to do in January, I've already done that. I did it on the 12th of January, so now I just maintain it throughout the year and start working on the next goals: front splits, box splits, and bridge, and hopefully get the front splits goal in February. Calisthenics goals are all going to be done within the last month, so it's going to take a while to build up to them. And weightlifting goals are just to maintain strength. So my strength is actually going to go down a bit because I'm going to be losing body weight. and therefore my weightlifting goals are lower here than my goals for the year and what I've lifted last year. They're going to increase in the next phase because powerlifting and weightlifting moves up on the priority list, and then it moves to the very top in the winter period when I'm not tricking, and that's when I'll hit all my powerlifting goals in that time. So for the main focus, I have three sessions a week. So it's three tricking sessions per week in this phase. And then for the secondary focus, there is two sessions per week. And for the maintenance phase, there's one session per week. I've added a rest day or weightlifting day there. However, it'll be a very light day if so, because you can't fit all of the powerlifting weightlifting moves into one day. All right, that's step two done. All your goals are now written out with deadlines. The next step is to go into each of these sections here and plan it out in detail. This is going to be the most boring and frustrating part of writing a program because it's going to take a long while to write out. I'm not going to go through all of these because they're all pretty much the same, but let's look at the tricking goals. So I've got my tricks arranged into categories: kicking, tumbling, twisting, and floor work. And I've got three sessions a week, so I'm going to make a session dedicated to each of those things. Like I said, it's better not to do everything at the same time and just focus on one thing. So I want a session where I only focus on tumbling, session where I only focus on kicking and floor work, and a session where I only focus on twisting. So let's look at the tumbling goals. So I've got all the days written out, and then all the goals are written across the top. So in this first month, I'm just getting back to my pre-surgery level, so it's just drilling all the most basic prerequisites for these goals. And the next phase, I need to land standing full, punch front full. That's the only level one goal, in my tumbling phase. So if you look in this, these are all the level one goals, and then here's tumbling. That's the first goal I need to land in tumbling. So when I do a tumbling session, I'm going to drill everything written out here, which is a prerequisite for these goals. So a prerequisite for a full punch front full is a standing full punch front. So in my tumbling session, I did that, and here's the clips. That was the 8th of January. So on the 15th, I'm gonna drill that some more. On the 22nd, I'm gonna drill it more. 29th, I'm gonna drill it more. It's gonna get better and better. And then in the next month, I have four sessions to turn that front flip into a front full. I can already front full pretty easy, so it should be doable. And everything just goes through this cycle of working through the prerequisites, and eventually, step by step, little by little, you get to the goal. It's the same for the kicking phase and the same for the twisting phase. I've got floor work within the kicking sessions as well. So I wanted to do 10 circles on the pommel horse and 7 flares on the pommel horse and 1 windmill on floor. Each session, these goals just get minutely harder. So within a week, I just need to do 1 more circle on the pommel and 1 more flare on the pommel. And eventually I'm gonna get all those goals. It's gonna be tiny little steps until I hit them. All right, that's it. I'm not gonna go into too much more detail. The other tabs, like the calisthenics phase, exactly the same. All the goals written across the top, and just little by little increasing things until I hit those goals. So yeah, if you wanna have a look, click the link in the description, have a look at the program. This is, like I said, this is very tailored to me, so it's not going to be appropriate for probably anyone else. The perfect program out there for you exists, but only you can write it because you have very different goals to probably everybody else. I'll leave you with some clips from the tricking sessions. So some highlights from the Monday's tumbling session, the Wednesday's kicking and floor work session, and the Friday's twisting session. I did all of the prerequisites, all went fine. So everything is on track. I hope this was useful. Let me know if you have any questions in the comments, and I'll come back to you.
Yes!
Six. First time I've thrown it.
Yes! Radio.
Other side. Yes. First goal of the year done. Oh, that hurts. Now I just need to make that easy when it's cold.